Okay, well, I found a mechanic. That's a good start. Okay, I'm slowly getting off this truck.
Well, I might be stranded on the side of the road waiting for the mechanic, but at least I can make myself a coffee. So, not the most hygienic of settings, but fuck it. It is what it is, right?
One thing I struggle about in South America, particularly in sort of Chile and Argentina, is the elongated lunch hour. And when I say hour, I mean, so the mechanic has 3 hours for lunch.
This is Claudio, and Claudio is going to get the orange Kombi fixed.
Have an apurado, correcto?
Sí.
Excelente, bueno.
Of destiny.
This is going to be a tough couple of weeks. I've just had to have a shower in the street with my watering can, so...
I am the lighthouse. I am the sea. I am the air that you breathe. To me.
And Charlie just saw me on the side of the street in the car, and it just so happens that he's your tu hijo? Tu hijo?
The my son.
Yeah. His son's business is a hostel. And I'm going to go stay in a hostel for a couple of days. It'd be nice to have a bed and everything. So for $5 a night, I'm like, yeah, let's do it.
It's Charlie's son. And these guys are going to go and get the Kombi for me, put it in a secured lockup place. And then, and his wife is doing my washing. I mean, this Argentinian kindness, man, this stuff is unbelievable. I am, I'm touched. Thank you, guys.
Right, so the long and the short of it is, I need a new engine. And I don't even know if there's any parts in the engine I've got that could be salvaged. I mean, there is, it's, the damage is terminal. I mean, there's fucking metal and shit everywhere inside it. The thing's blown apart. The Orange Kombi adventures will continue. Obviously, I guess the greatest things in life are on the other side of hardship and fear. And it just makes me appreciate it a lot more when things get a bit more difficult. Okay, so first day into search for new engine. It's proven to be somewhat difficult. It's the customs. They basically prohibit anyone bringing new auto parts into Argentina. But at the moment, I've not come up with any options that are tangible. But I'm out there looking, so fingers crossed.
This world is coming out to keep us from each other.
So I was on the street across the road, and my van was obviously outside with no engine in. And I just happened to, that obviously I was speaking English, and Glenn is from Canada, and his wife, who's Argentinian, and this is his family, and now I'm at their house having a meal. I mean, I was going to say Argentinian kindness, but it's sort of like Canadian-Argentinian kindness. And this is what's happening right now. I mean, this is what it's all about. Kindness is the way forward.
The plot thickens. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't having slight moments of anxiety over this engine thing. The Eduardo have said it is not possible to import an engine. So I cannot bring any parts into this country. I don't understand why, but it is illegal. In hindsight, maybe getting a different sort of car would have been probably a much better pragmatic idea, but I didn't. So I can't change that. If I can get a block that we can, you know, put everything together back onto, great. Then that will make a big difference. And then,
oh dear, dear, dear. Well, there's the engine now.
That's where it needs to go.
This is sort of like very affordable towing, but I don't know what cost.
Anyway.
That's what it should look like, and that is what it does look like.
I am the sea. I am your destiny.
Right, it's the first 150 kilometers done, so we've got about 100, 106 kilometers to go. I've got to say, this is the fastest the Kombi's ever gone. So, I mean, this guy's sitting at like 110. I'm fucking freaking out a bit, but it's certainly the best fuel mileage I've ever had because clearly getting towed all the way. But. Something inside your heart that is beating in time with. Okay, well, I finally got to the Kombi guy. I hope that's not his fucking idea of a Kombi. Holy shit, this could be bad. Okay, he's got a few Kombis here. I've been at their little shelves and they look fucked up. I don't know what the likelihood of me getting decent parts here is, but anyway, we'll find out pretty soon. Okay, this is quite unique. He's actually got a lot of Kombis up there. Okay, I've just got to the Kombi refugio, and I'm hoping that, well, there's certainly a lot of Kombis here. I'm not too sure what state the spare parts are going to be in. I'm just hoping that these aren't the other tourists that came here for help and ended up leaving their Kombis here, and this is what's happened to them. But he's got three blocks. That's a good start. I don't know. This is a Kombi refugio, and this is Walter. And Walter is the owner of the Kombi refugio. Check this out, this is a Kombi at Parisia. This place is amazing. It's like a Kombi graveyard. I'm hoping that my Kombi doesn't end up being here forever. Fuck. But it just rubs salt into the wound. I've just realized I've got a flat tire now, so I've run over a fucking nail as I've come in. But this place is unique.